Heavy hitters on the Shade 45 on a Monday.
It's a Low East Side reunion.
Low East Side is definitely in the building. Even though Money Nels lives in the Bronx now, not so good, man. What's up, man? How you doing?
Just busy, man. Just
I didn't know if you was coming. I'm here with 100.
Nah, I'm always here for you.
Because the girls was like, "Is he coming?" I said, "I don't know," because I hit him like after I was watching Game of Thrones, and I hit him like, "Yo, Tru, you coming?" He said, "What? I'm coming?" And then I don't know. I just said, "Yo, send me a picture." Then I still didn't know if he was really coming. But I'm glad you're here,
man.
Congratulations, man.
Thank you, man. Thank you. Just grateful, man. Just super grateful, blessed, man.
Still love. Shiny as ever.
Yeah, man. Just getting to it, man.
I'm not gonna lie. You make the low look real good. Because me and Money Nels representing the lower, it's not what's up.
That's what's up.
So what's new? Give me everything, man. We haven't talked since you came home. Yeah. I saw you at the other station's big concert that we do every year, and I was actually startled when I saw you, because I was like, oh, shit. Oh, shit. You know how you running and you move and you see a man, you be like, oh, shit. Oh, shit, what up?
Right.
But we didn't really get a chance to talk, man. So this is our first actual meeting, man, talking. And so much has happened since
yes, sir.
Since like you got this second coming of Tru Life, and now so just talk about it. Let the people know what's happening.
Yeah,
with
I just signed a new deal with my brother, man, Super Future and Epic and Free Bands, you know. So I'm just grateful for that. You know, when I first came home, I put out one record with Rick Ross. Shout out to Rick Ross. He definitely been a real one with me, you know. Mm-hmm. Always was there for me. So shout out to him. You know, I put out that record, but I didn't know what iTunes was, what Spotify was, what streaming was, what, you know, the social media has become now, you know, all the new platforms and how to break a record and, you know, to really do this. So I put it out and we got like 3 million downloads on YouTube. But
that's a lot.
Yeah, it's a lot, but I felt like the record was a great record and it could have been a hit record and it should have been a hit record, but I didn't really have the right platform to really put it on and I didn't know how to really work it. It just kind of did that on its own there without being on any, it's still not on any streaming sites now. Every kid got Apple Music, Spotify, they want it on their phone, they want to see it, they want to download it, it needs to be accessible. So the record wasn't accessible to the masses, so it wasn't able to go where it needed to go. And that record wasn't just a, you know, so I didn't want to waste these other records that I got that I feel like super special and just be a buzz record for Instagram and my, you know, little core fan base that knows that I'm home and not reach everybody and show the people that don't know I'm home yet and people that don't know me for them to get a chance to really feel the music. So I just took some time out to really find that right platform. And you know, when I first came home, the first person I spoke to, first phone call, was actually with Future. We spoke for like 35-40 minutes the whole way home, and I was in a Sprinter driving back, and he was just telling me, you know, how he was on top of the world right now, and how he would love to, you know, just roll with me and, you know, any which way he could help me. And he was like, "You my brother, you know, we come up from the dungeon together, doing records together, splitting a sandwich type shit in the dungeon with his cousin Rico." You know, I just told a story that how I know Rico, I met Rico Wade, which is his cousin, found organized, I mean, you know, Dungeon Family, CeeLo, and all those guys, and did all that. So, you know, Bubba Sparks was a close friend of mine. He was best friends with Bubba Sparks. Then, you know, we all became like really close friends.
Yeah, because I was about to ask, I'm like, my man, real talk, and this is not crazy, and I'm not shitting on my city, but the Low East Side always is like last to do anything. Yeah. And I was like, how? And I'm like, yo, how did Tru Life and Future get together?
Right.
So that was
the... And I didn't even hear nothing about it. And then... And then he got mad records with him. So I think it's a blessing. You know what I'm saying?
So that was like our connection. It came through the weirdest place, like through Bubba Sparks. Shout out to Bubba Sparks. You know what I'm saying? So we just built that friendship throughout the years. And then, you know, when I went away, he became Future. Because before I went away, he was Meathead. You know, I know him as Meathead, you know, rhyming with him in a dungeon. And
that's,
you know,
so crazy.
We had a ton of records sitting in a dungeon right now that never came out, that we never put out. So when I came home, then it turned into this. And then, you know, I had figure it out. I figured it out. And then the timing was right. We did a bunch of records together. We leaked the record with Clue that we gave the Clue.
Right.
And then that was that. You know what I'm saying?
So I like that.
Started to take off, and then we just decided to do the deal with him, because I felt like I needed that platform, and I didn't think there was a better person that fits me to actually, that I would want to ride side to side with and really go to bat, because I know the work I'm about to do right now. So if I was going to do it with anybody, it would be him, my brother.
All right, good. All right, so why don't you just introduce the record that we about to play for the world.
Yeah, this is my new record right here, man. It's called Last Night. Me and the boys, Super Future. Shout out to DJ Clue. And this is it. Let's go, baby. Turn up time.
Shout out to Pedro, too. Shout out to Pedro.
Yeah, shout out to my bro, Pedro, man.
Pedro's probably somewhere with a baseball bat waiting.
Yeah, shout out to Pete, man.
Shade 45.
Hey, yo, this is Big Spanish DJ Enuff. You're checking out the world famous heavy hitters, baby.
Yo, you gotta see his Texas. Yo, come on, we going on the road, son. We out. I'm gonna take you to the Yankee game first, and then me and Tru Life, we going on the road.
I feel
like I love that nigga, man.
Shit.
They don't have no clue. What motherfucker happened? Burn this bitch down, land a jet or anywhere. Streets love us.
Yeah, last week they ride the plug. Last night he got a body. I don't need no extendo. One shot to the mind. I can even wear odd numbers, 3, 5, 7s, and 9s. Mogul tree, free band chain. I'm down to die for that shine.
Man, legendary gang gang. Outside of
the crowd. You see him? You see him? You
see him? FPG gang. You proud of him?
You
proud of him?
Rose in my fruit loose. Hard time I done did that. Came home, nigga still pussy. Can't take my shit back. Trap, trap, trap. I feel this. We go back to red light.